FM News. On point. Joining us in the latest update coming in from the U.S. as we follow up on the electoral votes. U.S. President Donald Trump has hinted an early victory in the U.S. elections against Democratic Party's Joe Biden. Trump is still trailing with 213 votes against Biden's 238 electoral votes. The winner of the U.S. presidential election must get 270 electoral votes. So earlier today, Donald Trump addressed his supporters at the White House and said they will soon be declared winners.
If you look and you see Arizona, we have a lot of life in that. And somebody declared that it was a victory for, and maybe it will be. I mean, that's possible. But certainly there were a lot of votes out there that we could get because we're now just coming into what they call Trump territory. I don't know what you call it, but these were friendly Trump voters. And that could be overturned. The gentleman that called it, I watched tonight, he said, well, we think it's fairly unlikely that he could catch. Well, fairly unlikely. And we don't even need it. We don't need that. That was just a state that if we would have gotten it, it would have been nice, Arizona. But there's a possibility, maybe even a good possibility. In fact, since I saw that originally, it's been changed and the numbers have substantially come down just in a small amount of votes. So we want that obviously to stay in play. But most importantly, we're winning Pennsylvania by a tremendous amount of votes.
However, Joe Biden also assured his supporters that they are on the right track to winning the election.
We believe we're on track to win this election. We knew because of the unprecedented early vote and the mail-in vote, it's going to take a while. We're going to have to be patient until the hard work of tallying the votes is finished. And it ain't over till every vote is counted. Every ballot is counted. We believe one of the nets has suggested we've already won Arizona, but we're confident about Arizona. That's a turnaround. We also just called it for Minnesota, and we're still in the game in Georgia, although that's not one we expected. We're feeling real good about Wisconsin and Michigan. And by the way, it's going to take time to count the votes. We're going to win Pennsylvania.
The minister for Kampala, Betty Yamongi, has warned political supporters against causing violence in the city centre during the campaign period. Yamongi said it is wrong to attack anyone because of their political affiliation. She said people were being attacked near Shiseka Market and around Mini Price, questioning perpetrators.
We must remind ourselves that our action must push for messages that binds us together as a nation, not those that divide us. The election must reinforce messages that bring us together. We must make our diversity our greatest strength, not what divides us.
Now, the court has released the Equal Opportunities Commission boss Livia Mwebwa Ntambi on bail after presenting substantial sureties. Mwebwa was remanded to Kegel last week over charges of corruption, abuse of office, after failing to satisfy court with their documents. Today, she appeared through video conferencing before the High Court. Mwebwa, through her lawyer, Magdusman Kabega, presented three sureties, including Livia Namuvidu, the Lapsnet boss, and other friends the state prosecutor did not object to. Magistrate Moses Nabenden, releasing the accused, told her to deposit her land title and her passport to avoid unnecessary movements abroad and 3.5 million Uganda shillings cash, and sureties bonded at 40 million each, not cash. The case was adjourned to November 24th when she's expected to be committed to the High Court for trial. Police is holding a man suspected to have been conning people through selling to them land without titles or with fake titles. Godfrey Lutu, a resident of Kawuku, located along Kampala Entebbe Road, is being interrogated by operatives for allegedly conning over 90 million shillings from a police officer to whom he sold a fake land title in Chagwe. Lutu is suspected to be a member of a group that operates in the areas of Entebbe, Wakiso and Mukono and obtains money by false pretense from individuals, according to the PRO CID Charles Twine. Twine says that they have also the names of the 42 people who are behind this mission and they're looking for them. In other news, the International Criminal Court has confirmed that it is conducting a preliminary examination into the recent hashtag #NSAS protests in Nigeria. In a statement, the office of the ICC prosecutor said it had received information on alleged crimes. The examination will assess whether the legal criteria for opening an investigation under the Rome Statute are met. For weeks, crowds of peaceful protesters gathered in streets in major towns of the country to demonstrate against police brutality, leading to a crackdown. Some 51 civilians, 11 police officers, and 7 soldiers were killed, according to Nigerian President Muhammadu Buhari. Rights group Amnesty International said security forces opened fire on protesters, killing and injuring a number of people. Both the police and the army have rejected Amnesty's allegations. The ICC said it would make findings of the preliminary examination public. That was the news.
XFM News on point.